Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Today's episode is the first in a series where I'll teach you how to make your own music with GarageBand for iPad. In today's episode, let's look at creating the drum track. So let's launch GarageBand and start by creating a new song. Now, there are two different ways to add a drum track. You could use the drums, or if you flip through, you can use smart drums. Let's start with looking at smart drums. What smart drums does is it presents you with this grid, and it presents you with buttons on the left and right. So on the left, you can choose the type of drums that you want. So let's start with, say, a classic studio kit. And then that determines what buttons you see on the right. So the buttons on the right are then, they're really icons. You can click and drag, tap and drag over into the grid. And you can see the grid vertically represents the volume for the beat. And then left to right is changes the variation on it. So for instance, if we wanted to do, say, just a snare drum, we can put it in here. We can put it in all the way to the left. And it'll be very simple. And we can hear it. It's basically just ticking away. Whereas if I move the drum over a couple, it gets a little more complex. It's a little harder there. Let's move it over here. And now you can see it's actually three different hits to it each time around. It gets even more complex as we go all the way to the right. So now the idea is to drag various icons over and place them wherever you want on the grid. And then you can adjust it, say if I wanted hi-hats to be a little bit louder, and tambourine in but very quietly and simply. So it's very easy, basically it's just drag these around and create nearly countless number of different loops. You can drag any one you want off like that. You can also hit the randomize button there at the bottom left just to create a different one. Reset takes everything away. You can also shut it off by hitting the little power button to the left, and that allows you to drag things in and then kind of quiet it down for a second while you plan your next move. Now, once you like what you've got, you can simply hit the record button at the top of the screen. And that will record what's going on. You can make changes live while this is happening, or just let it record what you've got there so far. Hit the stop button at the top to stop it. Now that green area there is the area that you've recorded. Now at the top you've got that little drum icon and then your tracks icon. You go to tracks icon and it goes there, and you can see there the drums, that section that you recorded right there, and that's how you get it into a song so you can add other instruments. Now let's select that track here and delete it and record drums the other way, which is use the regular drums here. And this gives you what looks like a drum kit, and then you can tap on anything you want. And it even makes different sounds depending upon where on the instrument you hit. So we can change the type of kit. You can see some of them are a collection of buttons, and others are like visual drum kits that you could play. And now you can record here and record what you want. And now you've got that, and you could play it back. And when you go to look at your song, you see that that recorded track is in there. One thing I do want to show you is you can actually edit this. You tap on it and it gives you a bunch of different options here. You can hit edit, and in there you can actually see the different drum hits, and you can actually stretch them out or shorten them, lengthen them, move them. So you can really have a lot of control over what you want. And basically painstakingly build a beat exactly So if you're looking to actually create your own music to say be background for videos, for something else, you can actually just use this very simple technique to create kind of a drum loop. It could be unique and could be yours, and then you can share it out of GarageBand into iTunes and then use it elsewhere. Later on we'll be looking at how to add guitars, keyboards, and other instruments to your song. Until next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.